Okay, so make sure at this point we do the fun rope. And then just gonna get rid of that litter. Okay, so any spillage of the litter, make sure you blend it away with the fun brush, otherwise it makes it too fun. Depends on your model, okay? So we're gonna do, I'm gonna show you how to do a white, for some brides up, we're maybe gonna go whiter, okay, with their foundation. Okay, so we're gonna use 42 instead of Orient and an Ivy, okay, just around the mouth area, we warm up a little bit. Then I'm going to take ivory, and this time I'm going to use ivory all over the face. Okay, so I'm using ivory all over. So we're going to lighten the base, okay? So we warm up 42 first, okay, and then ivory all over.
It's fine. Try to do as much as I can.
Yeah. Actually, you know, they don't think that's...
It's for the country for me, and I try to do as much as I can. So just make
it. Okay, then I'm taking NC15, okay? Max Studio Fix. Sorry, you can use NW10 or you can use NC15, okay? Any of these two shades will work fine, okay? So I've used a little bit of NC15 and NW10. Okay, because it's, there's a very big demand, isn't there?
Mix it
with the chroma.
Mix 50-50, ratio 50-50, mix equal.
You can mix in NC15 and NW10.
While Neil just did that, I just want to let you know that if you look on the stage and look on the left hand side screen, it actually shows a similar colour on live, but this screen just seems to show literally the total opposite colour. I think it's too much brightness on it.
NW10, NC15. Okay, this is the last I'm going to finalise. If people are asking over and again, I'm being frustrated. Okay, so please listen. So this is for on clients, okay, that are maybe want to go lighter in skin, okay? There's a big craze in India and Pakistan about being white, okay? But not in England, okay? But if your clients do want to go whiter, then you need the NW10 because it has a pink tone in it, okay? So the NC15 gives you a warmness to the skin, okay? And then the NW10 will lighten the skin. So clients are under the eyes and around the mouth, and then you can use ivory. Okay? So just bear in mind, it depends on the skin that you're working with. So if your models today are dark complexion, and if you make them look lighter, make sure you do all the neck today and the chest area. Okay? Because we do this for bridal makeup, we always do the chest area and the neck area. If your model's very, very dark, then use oriental first, okay? Then 1W on top, then your liquid foundation's over.
Name in Pakistan, people also use orange corrector, the 508, to conceal dark.
Yeah, you can do, but not in England, we don't use it. You can, Oriental has enough orange pigment. Mm-hmm. Okay, but if you want to use that, you can do. any area where you can see that natural skin. Much heavier. If you want to lighten the skin, you've got to build a foundation. I don't think some of you are not very confident with foundation. Okay? You have to build it up much heavier. She's quite light skin, but if your model is dark, then you have to use Orient. Okay? If your model is light, then you can use 42 as a character. Okay, so I'm going to use a lighter translucent powder this time. So you can see it's almost like a white powder. Okay, so any translucent powder will do. Okay, this one is a max factor one again. Okay, max factor translucent one, the color. You can order this online. Max factor you can get in here. I don't know, can you?
I don't think so.
It's not
even online.
Yeah, just order it online. Okay, I'm saying on the cheeks. Okay, I still feel some people are confused with the cheek contour. Okay? So just remember, again, I will repeat, it depends on the face shape. If somebody has a wide face shape, you come in from the top of the ear, okay, towards the corner of the mouth. If somebody has a long face, then you come from the middle of the ear, okay, and towards the corner of the mouth. Okay, so I'll just put that brush there as a guideline. And I'm just going to contour. So make sure you get your positioning right. Okay, I feel some people are going either too low, or some people are not correcting depending on the face shape. So contour accordingly, please.
So this is a 9-2-4 brush you have?
Mark 2-2-4. Mark 2-2-4. And I'm mixing the light and the medium contour together. Really helps it to make it easier when you're contouring. You can use a white powder line or just hold the brush here, like this. And always coming from the ear towards the corner of the more definition. Then just use your white powder lines and leave them there to the end. So that will just define the cheekbones a little more you can get this line away at the end. So you never go below this line, okay? So for a long face you could lower, for a wide face you position higher from the top of the inner line. Okay?
So for her face, do you prefer the mid?
Middle, she has a long face. So I'm just going to take the powder and just go down the nose. Flat brush to the nose. So what people are doing on the nose, I've noticed, okay, you're just drawing, okay, you're creating two lines like this and just leaving, okay, that's not how you contour. Yes, you do go up and down, but then you've got to blend to the side of the nose, okay. You can either use your brush, okay, or you can just use your finger and blend, okay. So this nose contour is blending to the edge of the nose. Just like this, they have to blend down to the side of the nose, like this.
Guys, I'm just gonna stop you there because some of you guys are making videos. It clearly says no videos on your thing. I have a clear indication of who's been recording, and I'm individually gonna come and ask you to open your phones today. It's one rule for all, guys. There's some of you students who are being so cooperative and just taking
this technique to mixing. It creates a little bit more of a photographic play. Okay, and I'm just going to add a little bit of colour to the cheeks.
Yeah, just keep away from the light, either side, and if it's already, you can take a picture.